Today, in this lecture, we will be discussing distance vector routing protocols. Routing update. Routing table update occur periodically within the topology in a distance vector protocol network changes. Topology changes update proceeds systematically from router to router. Distance vector algorithm call for each router to send its entire routing table to each of its adjacent neighbors. The routing table includes information about the total path cost as defined by the matrices. Distance vector routing metric. Convergence is the speed and ability of a group of inter-networking devices running a specific routing protocol to agree on the topology of an inter-network after a change in the topology. Network has converged when all routers have consistent knowledge and correct routing tables. Routing loops can occur when inconsistent routing tables are not updated due to slow convergence in a changing environment. If a network has not converged, the following are possible: inconsistent routing table, inconsistent traffic forwarding routing loops. Routing loops invalid update will continue to loop until some processes stop the looping. This condition is called count to infinity. Packet loop continuously around the network in spite of the fundamental fact that the destination network is down. These packets loop through the network because of wrong information in the routing tables. Routing loops. To reduce routing loop and counting to infinity, RIP uses the following technique: count to infinity, split horizon, poison, reverse, hold down counters, triggered update. Routing loop count to infinity. Distance vector routing algorithm are self-correcting, but a routing loop problem can require a count to infinity. When a routing table update is received by a router in a distance vector network, the loop, the hop count for the updated route is incremented by 1. Without counter measure to stop the count to infinity process, the distance vector metric of hop count increment each time the packet passes through another router. To avoid this problem, distance vector protocol define infinity as a specific maximum number. With this approach, the routing protocol permit the routing loop to continue until the metric exceeds its maximum allowed value. Loop split horizon. Another possible source for a routing loop occurs when incorrect information that has been sent back to a router contradicts the correct information that the router originally distributed. Split horizon attempt to avoid this situation. If a routing update about a network arrives from a router, the router that received the update cannot send information about that network back to the router that originally sent the update. Split horizon thus reduces incorrect routing information and reduces routing overhead. Split horizon. The split horizon rule is based on the theory that it is not useful to send information about a route back in the direction from which it came. If router A received an update from router D, it would not send that information back to router B. Routing loop route poisoning. Route poisoning is used by various distance vector protocol in order to overcome large routing loop and offer explicit information when a subnet or sub-network is not accessible. Route poisoning accomplishes this by setting the hop count to 1 more than the maximum. The maximum hop count for RIP is 15. Table update. The routing tables are sent to neighboring router on a regular basis. RIP update trigger every 30 seconds. However, trigger update is sent immediately in response to some change in the routing table. The router that detects a topology change immediately sends an update message to adjacent router that in turn generates triggered update notifying the adjacent neighbor of the change. Timer. A count to infinity problem can be avoided by using hold down timer. When a router receives an update from a neighbor indicating that a previously accessible network is now inaccessible. The router marks the route as inaccessible and start a hold down timer. If at any time before the hold down timer expires, an update is received from the same neighbor indicating that the network is again accessible. The router marks the network as accessible and removes the hold down timer if an update arrives from a different neighboring router with a better metric than originally recorded for the network. The router marks the network as accessible and removes the hold down timer if at any time before the hold down timer expires, an update is received from a different neighboring router with a poorer metric, the update is ignored. Hold down timer helps prevent counting to infinity but also increase convergence time. The default hold down for RIP is 180 seconds. This will prevent any inferior route from being updated but may also prevent a valid alternative route from being installed. The hold down timer can be decreased to speed up convergence but should be done with caution. The ideal setting would be to set the timer just longer than the longest possible update time for the internet work. The ideal setting would be to set the timer just longer than the longest possible update time for the internet work. Set the hold down timer for just over 120 seconds, for example 126. One additional item that affects convergence item and is contemporary is the update interval. The default RIP update interval in Cisco IOS is 30 seconds. This can be configured for longer interval to conserve bandwidth or for shorter interval to decrease convergence time. To change the update interval, GAD router update time second.